How are you?
Jane Hicks, just how is he developing, and you know, how much further do you think it could be before he could be a real contributor?
Yeah, I mean, when Jay Reed had his little boo-boo of his finger the other day, Jaden went right in and ended up showing up on a couple of plays for us, and so he's developing exactly the way that we thought he would. And so, but as far as his role going forward, I think, you know, we can end up start seeing him a little more. Spags and I have talked about that, and so hopefully that's going to be coming soon. But heck of a football player, we would like to continue to get him in there if we can.
What's impressed you most about Trent so far this season?
His ability to be calm no matter where we put him on the defense, whether he's going to the corner position, whether he's sliding into the nickel position, just his ability to be able to move around, because last year he didn't have to necessarily travel around as much. But he's just a good guy that you can talk to about, hey, this is what we would like to do, whether it's bunch, stacks, whether it's, you know, a particular wide receiver, and Trent just never bats an eye.
In training camp, you were forward and kind of saying, we hope another cornerback steps up for two weeks. What's your assessment of how Jalen has done?
Yeah, Jalen has done a good job for us. You know, when he had the last preseason game and he didn't play so well, you know, that was a little digression for him. But since then, I mean, he refocused. He got back to the Jalen Watson that we thought that he would become. And so hopefully he would continue to ascend and going in the direction that he's currently going in.
With the running back, this dynamic, this Bijan Robinson, yes, both run and pass, what does the secondary have to be mindful of?
Have to be ready to, number one, not only the running back, you have to be ready to defeat blocks first. So Drake is a pretty daggone good blocker. He reminds me of an old Hines Ward throwback type blocker. As far as this young man is big body guy. So the number one thing we've been working on all week is making sure we take care of the first contact, which is our pressure key. And so, and then we can get to the running back next. But understanding that five is the guy that does a lot of the heavy lifting and being ready to crack replace, and if he's getting ready to block you, you better make sure you bring your lunch pail. But, and then you have to deal with the back next. And so I think a lot of people, when they are looking at this run scheme, their eyes are so focused on the back, and all of a sudden they're getting cracked, they're getting walled off. And so if you don't take care of the first line of defense first, for us offensive linemen cutting as well as wide receivers blocking, it's going to be a long day.
In your eyes, what makes technicians perfect for a timely defensive back blitz?
Oh gosh, I'm gonna leave that one to Spags. I won't answer that. All right, when I become the coordinator of the Raleigh Bull Little League team, then I can answer that question there.
Dave, I know you're joking about Justin's little boo boo, but his hands look pretty mangled after the game. I think one was cut, and he suggested a finger was broken.
Yeah.
What does it take to still be effective when you got that going on, and how much does that happen to D-backs having to deal with stuff with their hands?
Yeah, that was in my 20-something years, I don't think I've had a defensive back that had that type of a cut. And now to see him come back into practice and we go over and hit the sleds, there's nothing that we changed on our weekly routine, and he was able to go over and strike the sled still. I mean, so the kid is, the young man, he's not a kid, the young man is really mentally strong. I mean, Justin has a mentality that, you know, hey, let's move on. It's just a finger. Let's keep going. And so I know if that was me, I would probably be asking my wife to, you know, to just pray with me and just, you know, have some ice at home for me. But not Justin. He just continues to go. So, but I'm happy that we have a guy like that on our team, because other players are seeing that. And when other players see that, that's when you just start to gain that grit, those calluses on your fingers when you're lifting weights. And now you're getting teams coming in here, and they're coming into a culture where, like, okay, wait a minute, that's the standard. So I can't hold out if I have a little injury. So happy for them.
Now you got more work in too. Is that just a matter of getting him back into football shape and not getting the rest of them?
That's exactly right. I mean, Nazi Johnson, you're talking, you cannot – there's not a better human being in that locker room, in my opinion, than Anazi Johnson. He's always positive. He's always smiling. You know, brother man is his word. What's up, brother man? And, you know, and so, but Nazi is one of those guys to be able to get him going and playing in some of his first time NFL games. I mean, you think about it, he's been a special teamer. And going, when I say playing, I mean playing the corner position. Nazi is doing a great job for us, and he's going to continue to learn. I mean, he had the touchdown that he gave up the other day in the red zone, but he'll learn from that. But he's just a great young man who's, you know, we're happy that part of the Fab Five, that he's one of the fifth piece of that puzzle that's stepping up for us.
Thank you, Coach.
All right. Thank you, guys.